Let's talk about the macro feature in HID Remapper. Macros lets you send a sequence of inputs by pressing just one key or button, so they could be useful for entering some predefined text or for things like a mouse double click triggered by just a single click. Before I show you how macros work, let me show you one use case where you might think that you need macros, but you actually don't, because it can be implemented with simple mappings. That use case is when you want one key or button to trigger a key combination like Ctrl-C or Alt-F4. You might be tempted to use a macro, but you can just do this instead. Let's say you want the right mouse button to send Ctrl-C. You can create one mapping with the right button as input and Ctrl as output, and another mapping with the right button as input and C as output. These will work simultaneously. When you click the right button, HID Remapper will send both Ctrl and C at the same time. Okay, but let's say you want the right mouse button to enter some text. We can't do that with simple mappings, we'll have to use a macro. Let's create a mapping that has the right button as input and macro 1 as output. Now, whenever we click the right mouse button, macro 1 will be executed or triggered. All that is left to do is to define that macro. As you may have guessed, we do that in the Macros tab. Let's say we want the right button to enter Hello with a capital H. Let me expand macro 1. When I click the plus button, it adds an entry to the macro. But now there are two kinds of plus buttons. This one adds another row, and this one adds another item to this row. Each row defines a combination of keys or buttons that will be sent simultaneously. And the rows are sent one after another. So let's define our hello macro. I said that I wanted to start with a capital H, so the first row must be shift and H. Then just a single key per row. E, L, L, O. Okay, let's save this configuration to our HID Remapper and test it. Save to device. Let's go to Notepad. And now I'm clicking the right mouse button. It's entering hello, but with a single L. Can you see why? When HID Remapper is executing this macro, it's sending these keys or key combinations one after another. But between each row of the macro, there is no period where all the keys are released, so the two L's are just a single key press twice as long, resulting in only one L being typed. If we want a break between rows, we have to specifically tell HID Remapper that we want it. And we do that by having a row that just says nothing. Let's redo the macro. I will delete the last two rows. I'll add a row that just says nothing. And then I'll do the rest of the macro as before. L and O. By the way, here at the top, you can see a short representation of the macro. Shift plus H, E, L, nothing, L, O. Okay, let's save this new configuration and see if it works. Now when I click the right button, we get a proper hello. Success. There's one more setting that I haven't mentioned yet. It's in the Settings tab. Here, macro step duration. As you can see, it's 1 millisecond by default. When our macro is just for entering some text, we don't really have a reason to slow it down. We want it to work as fast as possible. But there are situations where we might want the macro to be executed a little slower. We can do that using this setting. If I change this to, say, 100 milliseconds, then each row of the macro will be held for that long. Let's save it and check if we can see a difference. Previously, the text was entered instantaneously, and now we can see it being typed. Let's make it even slower. The maximum we can set is 256 milliseconds. You can see that it's even slower now. This setting is global, so you can't control the length of every step of a macro individually. You could try to get around that by setting the macro step duration to the greatest common divisor of the desired step lengths, and then making duplicate rows in the macro. Okay, that's it for this video. If you have any questions, please leave a comment. To learn more about HID Remapper, visit the project's GitHub repository. Thanks for watching!